He was not threatened. He said, my brothers, this is the day, like the day our Lord Jesus was arrested. Remember, he knew what was going to happen.
And indeed it happened. Archbishop Janani Luwum is believed to have been killed in the evening of 16th February 1977, somewhere in the dungeons of the notorious State Research Bureau in Nakasero, Kampala. There are a number of accounts explaining the events of that fateful day. According to retired Captain Isaac Baker, who was a soldier in the Uganda Army at the time, each of the venerable men who the President had summoned to the International Conference Center that day was ready to meet death. But Janani Luwum seemed ready more than everybody else. Baker, then in his late 20s, was an officer in the Uganda Army. Earlier, Archbishop Luwum had ordained him as a church minister at Bishop Tucker Theological College, present-day Uganda Christian University. He was later appointed the chaplain of the Air Force Base in Gulu. He also oversaw spiritual matters among the Air Force officers in Entebbe and Nakasongola. Baker was among the religious, government and military leaders President Amin summoned to the International Conference Center, present-day Kampala Serena International Conference Center.
Then Brigadier Isaac Maliamungu, who acted as MC, announced in Kiswahili that leo ni leo. Leo tutasema ukweli, kulikuwako wakati watu wakizumuza sana, wakitoa uvumi na uongo, lakini leo ni siku ya kuhakikisha nani ni nani.
The Archbishop had a premonition that the meeting would not end, but he still showed up. The plan to execute Archbishop Luwum seemed to have been well crafted. According to Baker, Amin's right-hand man, the notorious Brigadier Mali Yamungu, was the master of ceremony. But at certain moments in the meeting, he played judge, saying some people whose names he never mentioned were traitors preaching the gospel of blood.
Then he brought in one young man who appeared to have been thoroughly tortured, called Lieutenant Ogwang. He was made to read a long, well-written statement. It appeared from a document that had been well written, because the language that was used was highly political.
Accounts by eyewitnesses and researchers agree that President Amin was in the vicinity, in the presidential suit at the Nile Mansions, just about 50 meters from the conference center. The statement, which was a confession to subversive activities, was carefully structured to bring into picture Archbishop Luwum, former Inspector General of Police Serena Yoriema, who also served as Minister of Physical Planning, and Interior Minister Charles Obothofumbi. A number of firearms allegedly procured by the trio were displayed before journalists. Less than 2 weeks earlier, the Archbishop's residence on Namirembe Hill had been searched and no firearm was recovered. This incident prompted clergymen to write a hard-hitting letter to President Amin on 10th February 1977. Archbishop Luwum was known for publicly condemning government for acts of kidnap, extrajudicial killings and indiscipline in the army. The letter signed by Luwum and 18 bishops was copied to all religious leaders. Some historians have concluded that this might not have gone down well with Amin, who felt that the clerics were challenging his authority.
All of us were ordered to vacate where we were, to go inside the conference hall. When everybody went in the conference hall, we all went there. The same Maliamungu came back again and announced that now there are clergy in the following department: the chaplaincy in the armed forces, if you are a reverend there, join your colleagues.
Inside the conference center, the clergymen were ordered to move to an upper room where they were confined.
Yalinga on the street. Then immediately, I think Amin entered. We heard the clamping and all that going on, then playing of national anthem. I heard him ask, tufanye nini na watu wa dini kama hawa wanaohubiri umagaji wa damu? Then the soldier said, whoa, Maliamungu comes with these men, opens the door, announces, you clergymen who are killers and preaching gospel of bloodshed, this is last warning to you, the rest of you. But Luwum, you are under arrest.
Archbishop Luwum was singled out and taken away. The others were ordered to leave the premises in 10 minutes. Bishop Silvanus Wani, who would later succeed Luwum as Archbishop, tried to confront the soldiers. The clergymen were powerless. They could not do anything more than that. According to Baker, Bishop Wani was the only person who stood up to President Amin.
So Somebody told me, he said, Isaac, you know the man is not in a good mood. Now why have you? I said, no, Mr. Brigadier, it's not me. This is the bishop. I can't order the bishop. He said, okay, come with him. So bishop was in following me. Then I ushered him in. As he enters in, Amin is sitting there, cross-legged with a big pistol in his waist. The bishop went, when Amin said, please sit down, said, no, I can't sit on your blood-stained carpet. Instead, I'm here to tell you, to ask you this. So he went straight to Amin, said, have you banned the Church of Uganda? Have you banned the Christian Church?
Baka claims that no sooner had Bishop Wani told Amin his mind than a phone rang, announcing something unusual to Amin.
You heard that?
I heard that. As the man, the colors. So when he said that, Amin sort of, I saw his body language put an expression of shock.
Baka's account contradicts others that put Amin at the scene of Luwum's murder, with claims that the president had fatally shot the archbishop in the mouth. The following day, news filtered in that Luwum, Oryema and Ofumbi had been killed in a car crash as they tried to flee. It is said the disagreement between Amin and Luwum stemmed from reports that the archbishop and others planned to overthrow his government with the backing of Tanzania. Some people argue that Luwum was accused of subversion because he had refused to give Amin part of the funds earmarked for celebrating 100 years of the Anglican Church in Uganda in June 1977. According to unconfirmed reports, the money was an offer from the main church in England to cover up their criminality. Some elements in government flew Luwum's body to his ancestral home in Mucwini Sub-county, Kitgum district, and ordered for an immediate burial, making it obvious that they were concealing evidence of murder. The man who later became archbishop began as a primary school teacher. He converted to Christianity in 1948 and studied at Wallace Theological College in Imbale. In 1953, he was ordained a deacon, then a priest in 1954. He served in the Upper Nile Diocese and Imbale Diocese before his transfer to Gulu Diocese as bishop. In 1974, he was appointed the Archbishop of the Province of Uganda, Rwanda, Burundi and Boga Zaire, present-day Democratic Republic of Congo. Luwum is recognized as a 20th century martyr by the Anglican Church, and his statue stands tall in front of Westminster Abbey in London, UK. Frank Walusimbi, NTV.